My name is Evan Conant. I was diagnosed with stage 1 colorectal cancer.
My name is Allison, and I was diagnosed with colorectal cancer.
I'm Carmisha, and I was diagnosed with stage 3B rectal cancer.
My name is Steven Estrada, and I was diagnosed with stage 4 colorectal cancer.
At age 52.
At the age of 32.
At the age of 40.
When I was 28.
I'm a wife. I'm a mother of two. I do photography.
I lived a life that was just really fun and exciting, and cancer was definitely never on my radar.
I had a great, healthy lifestyle, mountain biking, trail running, climbing mountains, skiing in the winter.
Right around 26, 27, 28, I felt like everything was sinking together, and my relationship was really starting to blossom, and we were looking at houses to buy. I mean, it was good.
For the most part, I'm pretty much still the same person. I just had cancer now.
And my jaw just hit the table. And I looked around, I'm like, you talking to me?
Wait, someone my age shouldn't get cancer. It's weird. I don't get it. So when I got that diagnosis, my life flashed before my eyes. And I really thought, I'm going to die.
We were on vacation right before my diagnosis in Jamaica. While everyone did, you know, the waterfalls and the hikes and everything, they had all this fun. And I was in the hotel room, doubled over in pain, bleeding. That was kind of the moment I knew.
I just got a get out of jail free card. And just 3 years ago, when I went through ambassador training with Fight CRC, half of my class that I was training with, they're gone now.
I was on the toilet all the time. I couldn't control my bowels. It was a nightmare. It was very hard to live every day and try to work every day. I had to know where the restroom was all the time. So it was rough.
No matter how much research you do, no matter how much people tell you to prepare and give you tips and tricks on how to prepare, experiencing something firsthand is always kind of like, it's been a ride. I will say that, it's been a ride.
I see terrible things every day, but I see things that give me so much hope even more.
Your story can help someone else. Your transparency can help someone else. So it's important, community is important.
Cancer does not define you. I think every story, every experience, every journey that people go on needs to be shared. And it's changed the person that I am today. I'm not happy that I got cancer, but I took what I got through my journey and my cancer story, and I changed my life for the better.